Hello guys, Carl and Kirk here with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Today I want to show you some tips about wire. How much do you cross over wire? I've done a lot of videos as far as how to apply lath, but I haven't addressed the question, and I've had a couple people call me and say, Kirk, you never say how much the wire has got to crisscross itself or overlap. Okay, on a horizontal like this, I just attach this wire with hammer tacker just to prove a point. On a horizontal, you want 3 inches, or you could say 3 squares. 3 squares is 3 inches, basically, actually almost 4. But say if you're going on a vertical overlap, like say, in a minute we're going to finish taking this wall up. We're going to paper it, and he's got to put his fascia board up there. But say you were taking the wire and you stopped it at this point here. Then you started from that side here and went, do you go to this stud? No, because they'll just be touching. What you would do is go to the next stud. That way, similar to sheetrock, you want to always be on a stud. That way you avoid the cracking. What I'm about to do now is, all our studs are marked with this, we use a yellow crayon. Every 6 inches, guys, every 6 inches. And what you do is you follow the line or the pattern of the wire. And what wire are we using? We're using a 17 gauge wire. It's a deep furred wire. I like a deep furred wire because we do a lot of same day double coat systems. So with a deep fur, it sticks out a little bit more. While we're on it, guys, why are we going over Densglass this way? Densglass sheeting is usually necessary if the house is within 3 feet of a property in some cities. So they got Densglass over plywood here. And so what we do is we just handle Densglass just like it's a plywood. So we put 2 layers of paper, we staple off into the studs. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, just like if it's plywood, guys. So, all right, what is if they have a gypsum based product in this sheeting right here? This is Densglass. It's a acrylic waterproof sheeting on the exterior as well as on the inside. It resists molds, all kinds of stuff, plus it gives you an extra fire ratio. Anyway, we're going to go to the gable here and show you something else, but I wanted to point out too, sit while we're here, this doesn't amount to anything as far as this video, but see these bars on this window? See this gate right here? See the gate to come in? See the gate to go out? The whole neighborhood is gated like that. Most of the houses here have gates on the front doors. They're decorative, but they're gates. And almost every house has this. The reason I point that out is because I grew up in this neighborhood. Me and Lou did. Well, of course, people, they call me and say, Kirk, what part of France did you grow up? And I say, what makes you think I grew up in France? And they go, with a name like Kirk Pierre Giordano, you had to grow up in France. I said, no, my mother grew up in France. We came here, she spoke 4 languages except for English. We ended up in this neighborhood. I'm a block away. We've lived here our first 17 years. Kind of fun, but at the same time, scary. A scary neighborhood. I thought I'd point that out and throw that out because the fella who I'm doing this for, he says, I hope you don't mind the neighborhood. And I got here, I thought, dude, I grew up in this neighborhood. It's somewhat vicious, but we had fun just the same. Anyway, I'm going to go to this gable, and I'm going to show you what I was going back on as far as how much to overlap this wire. All right, guys, I'll give you another example of how much to overlap. Somebody cut the wire a little too short here. Ooh. All right, so what I do is I took another piece of wire, same length as this. We put it here, go all the way to the corner. Then we take it past the stud. We don't just put a 3-inch piece here. Why? Because it could have a tendency to hairline crack the scratch or the brown coat. I'm going to go up here and I'll show you some last details, which folks say, gee, Kirk, hey, I'm doing this gable, and man, how do you overlap the gable? Well, okay, for example, now, I put a, notice I got my 3 holes for you DIYers, DIYers, do-it-yourself folks, 3 holes or 3 inches minimum. So we're overlapped here. I haven't stapled anything in yet. And when I got here, I said, dude, where's your where's your fascia board and your L-flash? And he said, what's that? I said, man, go to Home Depot and get yourself some 1x4s. What are you going to hang a gutter on? All the way around here, there's no 1x4s. So I said, you need on the sides, especially, you need the 1x4s. The 1x4s go on the paper, and then you need to put an L-flashing in here so the homeowner is actually going to get that for this other side. Here you don't need a gutter, it'll just drain off. But what I'm doing is he's still going to put a 1x4 here, so I'm cutting my wire here. Now I can do two things, guys, as far as overlap. I can take this wire I just cut and put it right here, but you see now I'm only 2 inches right here. So what I do is I'm going to take this, just discard it, and take this whole piece and put it right here. And I'm allowing for that 1x4 that he still needs to place on there. Is it better to use a whole bunch of wire like this rather than try to skimp and save? You betcha. So use excess wire than try to skimp and save, because you're not going to save anything if your scratch and your brown coat hairline crack. And while we're on the subject of wire, you know what I'm going to do is cut this out, this vent, and then I'm going to crisscross it the same way. Blam, one straggler like a sock in a dryer hanging in. All right. So this one here, because it's loose, I tuck it under here because we want our metal to go far under there. Here, the same thing, just like what we did. Here's a stud, guys, a stud. A stud is every 16 inches. We'll put that down, put this down, and account for his 1x4, which he's going to pick up right now. We take this off, get rid of it. Come on now. We get rid of it. Blam. Then we take this wire, and remember, guys, we always go with the arc. The arc goes on the wall usually because we want the fur. We want it to be furred out. So here, we're going to overlap it again. So I'm going to excess overlap it. Better to have excess, too much overlap, than not enough. And the same thing applies. I'm going to take my snips and cut this out. Now earlier when I was talking about this neighborhood, Lou didn't have as much of a problem as I did, because Lou was like well over 200 pounds. Me, growing up before I was 18, I was about 110, soaking wet, and man, I had some issues. But water under the bridge, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Anyhow, guys, now the last thing we're going to do is you're going to take your gun, and you got to have some eye protection. I've had staples hit steel straps, pop off, and hit me in the face. Imagine not wearing glasses, you could lose an eyeball. So now what we do is we follow the studs. So every 6 inches, guys, boom. Just to prove a point, I'll just take it down to here. We come up every 6 inches. And yeah, you can put a staple in the field too. See that? Because these wires can't be further than our scratch and a brown coat, otherwise they'll stick out. So occasionally you put the staple in the field too. You get your corners. I always like to double wrap my corners with paper and cut the corner. I don't wrap my corners. I never have, because if you do that, the corners won't attach properly, and then you end up using a hammer and pounding it, and you rip the paper. I have torn about 15 houses apart. I know this for a fact, guys, so I don't do it. A corner aid will tie that in, because the corner aid will go on here, and that gives you your overlap. So here again, we just follow the stud. Savvy? Follow the stud. And when he gets here with his, right here, where the stud is, we follow that stud. But I'm already on this stud. This is excess, so I can go in the field. This way we don't get hairline cracks, guys. Anyway, I had a fella say, gee, you haven't addressed that overlapping issue. How much? There it is. That is the overlapping that we generally do. And also, guys, furry nails are pretty outdated. The only time they use those are if you don't want to spend $300 for a gun, $300 for a noisy compressor, and for all the hoses. So we use wire that is self-furred. Wire's been self-furred for over 40 years now. Anyway, guys, I hope that explained how to overlap, and it's good to be in the old neighborhood. You can see all the fences still on the ground right here that are torn apart. How many of you folks don't appreciate a neighborhood where you can go out when it gets dark and play around? You grew up here, you get used to it, and you think, man, I like this neighborhood here. I can go outside, it's dark, and not get mugged. Anyway, my name is Kirk. I am with Kirk Giordano Plastering. We thank you for watching, and as usual, see you guys on the next one. Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.